Hi everyone, this is the episode 4 of Building a Search Engine. This is going to be live, but there will be video available on YouTube. And I'm going to enable and I'm going to record a screencast just in case. Okay. Arg. Sorry. Okay, so I'm going to post the address on Reddit. And in my Twitter. Going to check if it works. Okay, it works. I'm also going to post this in my Twitter. Okay, and I'm going to check how much time do we have. Okay, it's about 2 more minutes. I'm going to wait 2 more minutes and then I'm going to start coding. Meanwhile, I'm going to set up the chat. Okay, so few more seconds. So I need to set up a chat properly. Welcome everyone. So, okay, one moment. You can ask me questions in the chat and I will answer them. Also, in the previous episode, someone asked me to enlarge, to make font larger, and I'm going to do this now. Where is it? I don't quite remember. Okay. So I'm going to change font to 18. Yeah, 18 too. And also, I'm using Python. I'm going to post the link here. And I think it's time to start working. I'm going to create tmux split. And I'm going to open the code. Okay, for persons watching, great. Just in case, these videos are going to be available on YouTube, so you can watch later if you want. And I'm going to start coding. So during the previous episode, we were building a crawler, and it's I think it's almost done. I would like to do two things first. I would like to do two more things. First is turn it into a proper script. So I'm going to make it invocable from command line, and it's not going to take a lot of time, I hope. Okay, so let's start doing this. Basically, I want to do, okay, so I'm going to start with reorganizing the code, actually. So I'm going to create util pipe where I'm going to put all the stuff. I'm going to move convenience functions there. And I'm going to turn search engine pi into crawler pi, which is going to I'm going to rename it into crawler pi. Oops. So I have this class here, crawler, and I want to make it a proper script. I mean the file. So here's how I'm going to do it. First of all, there is I would like to make crawler pi importable as a model. So for example, if I type it here, it will work. Well, I modified it, so it's not working now. But I also would like to invoke it from command line like this, and it should start crawling stuff. So this is Python magic. It checks if basically it's this condition means are we invoking it from command line, and if we are actually invoking it from command line, we are going to do some command line stuff. I usually make another function called main, but you don't really need to do this. And so first of all, I'm going to set up login. And then I'm going to create a crawler. And I think it takes two arguments, startur and storage dir. And what I want to do is just take it from command line. So I want to do something like this, Python crawler pi, start URL something, storage dir, some other dir. But it's not going to work right now. And to implement this, I'm going to use Python model called argparse. I actually used it in the past, but I would like to copy past some code. So it's, to do this, I'm going to import argparse. Then I'm going to create a parser. Description crawl. Okay, crawl return programming. And I'm going to add a couple of options, parser and argument. So, okay, let's see how it. First argument is going to be called start URL, and I think this is it. I think I need to add, oh no, yes, And there is another one called storage div. So by the way, Loretta told me here. I used this model in the past, so I'm not going to read all this stuff, but you may want to do it. It's pretty interesting and convenient model. So all right, start URL. So I'm going, so this is basics of Python parsing. So first of all, I would like to check if my parsing works. And to do this, I'm going to comment out this line, and then I'm going to just print parses up. Okay, let's see if it works. Okay, it seems to work. So basically, argparse takes this stuff and conveniently turns it into this stuff. So it's pretty awesome. Let's start crawler. And by the way, as you can see, this stuff is not going to be invoked if I do import crawler. That's because of this Python magic. So what I want to do now is just test our crawler. I'm going to go to our learn programming. I'm going to take this URL. It here. I'm going to. Oh, I have crawl tools here from the previous episode, but I would like to clean it just in case. If you haven't watched the previous episode, in crawl tools, stuff stored crawl tools, some crawl data are stored. Basically, the name of a file is base16 encode URL, and the contents is just HTML. So what I want to do now is just to run it. Didn't work. Okay, this is because I moved necessary stuff here. So I'm going just from util import start, and I think I use here login, and I use here rare, and I use the request. Okay, let's try another time. Let's do it here, by the way. So what I want to do now is just launch our crawler and move to the other stuff. Let's see. So it started working. That's nice. And now I would like to talk about indexing. So we have all these crawled URLs in the crawled URLs here. And now I want to build indexes. Indexes are basically some data structures that makes search easier. For example, there are two main types of indexes. Okay, let me open a new file. So we are going to use just two types of indexes. First is forward index, and the second type is inverted index. Inverted index is more important. Basically, what's forward index? Let's say we have a couple of documents. For example, doc one contains something like and this is words in the doc one. For example, learning Python how to. It's just an example. I'm going to show you on the real data. Okay, by the way, it stopped working for some reason. I'm going to get back to it once I finish explaining. So, and the second one, something like learning C++. So, the audio quality isn't great. Okay, I'm going to do something about it. Okay, I have Hangout somewhere. Okay, I don't know how to fix it. I tried to move closer to my laptop. Let me know if it improved audio quality. Okay, where is the chat? Okay. So I'm trying to move closer to my laptop. Did it help? So this is something like forward index, and inverted is basically just parsed documents, just a collection of parsed documents. So it's pretty simple. On the other hand, inverted index is more interesting. Let's say we have the same two documents, and inverted index is going to look like this. Okay, I'll try to improve the audio quality in my next streams. I actually tried not to use Hangouts and instead stream using Adobe, something like Adobe FML, but it didn't work for some reason. For some reason, it couldn't detect my webcam, So I wanted to show you my face, my webcam, but I wasn't able to make this thing work for some reason. And I hope I will be able to fix audio quality too using some other streamer rather than Google Hangouts. So inverted index is pretty cool because if we have some sort of query and something like learning. Okay, let's add the third doc. For example, it's going to just Python C++. Okay, so edit the third document to make it more interesting. So forward index basically is a map from documents to list of words, and inverted index is map from words to documents that contains these words. So let's say we have query learning Python, right? And we want to know which document contains these words. To do this, we take our inverted index, we take the query, we take word learning, and we know that it is in two documents, doc one and doc two, and Python is in two documents, doc one and doc three. And then we have these things, they're called posting lists. And we can do all sorts of stuff. For example, if we want to find all documents that contain both words, we just iterate over posting lists and basically find documents that are in both. In this small collection, it's not very convenient, or it doesn't make a lot of sense. For small collections, inverted index doesn't speed up, but if your collection is large, like gigabytes or megabytes, or if you crawl in the whole web, it's probably petabytes and even more. Having inverted index is super convenient because you can know exactly which document contain the words of the query. All right, so I hope this makes sense. By the way, there is a cool book called, I think, Introduction to Information Retrieval. Retrieval. Okay, I found it. So here is the book, I think. It's pretty cool, you might want to read it. And it probably explains this concept better than me. I'm going to update, I'm going to update the description of the video event link. Okay. I hope I didn't broke it. Okay, it still works. Okay. I worry that I will stop the broadcast if I update this stuff.
Sorry, I'm going to update.
How do I fix it? Okay, never mind. I will update it, the description after the recording. And now I'm going to see why it can't, why there is an error. Line 7 util py. Okay, what if I use Unicode? So what I want to do now is to fix our crawler so it doesn't stop crawling if there is an error. I'm going to just catch all the exceptions and log them. Try accept exception SE. I'll log in error. Okay, I'm going to comment out the debug stuff. Okay. Login. Sorry, it should be exception. Login exception. Login error. And error while crawling. Page error. Wow. If I did everything right, it should now log errors and just log errors and not crash. I'm also going to update log level, and then I'm going to check some statistics. URL count, increase your URL count here. I think I'm going to increase it here. I don't like that it is copy-pasted. It's kind of duplication and I don't like it, but I'm going to leave it like this for now, and I'm going to refactor it later, probably in the next episode. Okay, I'm going to increase the URL count here. And I think I'm going to print some stats here. Some stats. I think I'm going to print it every 100 URLs. Count plus all your account. So I think, okay, let's test it. Okay. Start a new HTTP connection. Okay. What I didn't like is that it's I don't really want to see these messages from requests, from request library. What I'm going to do? I think Python allows you to set level for each module. So I'm going to read some docs. Okay. Let's see if it works. I'm not good at logging. I'm not good at it. Okay, I'm going to do this. Replace all occurrences of login dot with login at logger name and see if it works. It's kind of ugly, but I'm interested whether it works or not. Let me see. Yes. Good. Okay, let's see if it works. No handlers could be found for logger name. Okay. Not handler. I'm just trying to make it work. I mean, I just want to see info messages from my code, but not from request library. And let's see if it works. Didn't work, or maybe like this. Okay, let's set up a formatter. Maybe that's the problem. Okay, let's try this way. Why isn't it working? Okay, what if we replace name with something like test logger. Everywhere except this place. Global name test logger not defined. Okay. This is because I forgot oops. I don't like it that it isn't working, but I think I'm going to give it a couple more minutes and then move to the other stuff. I'm not sure how interested are you in watching all this trial and error. For some reason it's not working. Let's I think I'm just going to debug it for a couple of minutes. Still no. Okay. Okay, I'm going to stop debugging. I'm going to figure out why it wasn't working later. For now, I'm going to just add some nice format into log. Let's see if it works. It doesn't work. Why? So let's look at the damage I had done. Oops. What the dot? Maybe I should put it here. I don't know. Okay. Let's put it here and see if it works. Why is it important? Okay. We can set level. So regarding the damage I done, I think it wasn't too boring. I don't want to spend too much time just trying to make it work by trial and error. And I think I'm going to read some stuff about logging. Maybe take another half an hour, or maybe an hour. And I'm going to update it during the next episode. And for now, let's go back to working on indexer. So, okay, nice, works. So I'm going to create a class indexer that's going to take part to documents and create some files on the disk with indexes. By the way, you can totally ask me messages, questions in chat. I will be happy to answer them. On the indexer. So don't hesitate to do it. And for now, I'm going to call indexer. So I probably will need some data. So it's going to have one method, and it's going to be called add document. URL and parsed text. So here I'm going to initialize two indexes, inverted index. And I'm going to represent it as shift and forward index. And it's also going to be a div. So what else do I need? By the way, our indexer is going to assume that the collection fits in memory. And I want to create something minimal first, and then I'm going to expand. I think eventually I'm going to ask code that allows to index collection that don't fit into memory. And by memory, I mean RAM. So, but for now, I'm going to create a really, really simple solution. So in some later episode, I'm going to make it more advanced. But right now, I'm going to just create something super simple. So first of all, I would like to, we need to, in inverted index, we need to store doc 1, doc 2, and stuff like that. So basically, we need to store some sort of identifier. And while URL is an identifier, it's not a good one. First of all, there could be two documents with one document may have two different URLs. So for example, I'm going to show you on Reddit. So here is our document. And if I type here something like npreddit.com, it's still the same document, but the URL is different. And another thing about URLs, they can't be long. I mean, it's like 20, I think. Okay, it's 100. Its length of it is 100, and I think it's not very good. I don't like it. It would be better if our identifiers your integer. So I'm going to store like URL to ID, and ID is going to be an int. And I'm going to store how much documents we have indexed. Okay. So So in add document, I'm going to just increase the count of documents, right? But then I'm going to put it into forward index. And because forward index is super simple, what I need to do is just take current ID. Current ID is going to be dot count. And so I'm going to assume that no URL. So it assumes two things, that no document is So it assumes that we add a document only once, and also assumes that for now, it assumes that a document has a unique URL. Like I said, we will probably modify it later, but for now we are going to make this assumption, and I think it's actually to do. You know these assumptions. So these are to do's. I'm going to check that URL was indexed. Not in this cell. Well, and then I'm going to put this document into a forward index. So current ID is just the total document count, and we increase it every time we get new document. So it's good. And parsed text is just list of words. So now we are going to put our documents into inverted index. So to do this, we are going to just iterate over parsed text. Forward in parse text, self inverted index of from word. Okay. If we never encountered word words, then it's not in inverted index yet. So we need to make it make an empty list. Actually, I think we could use default dict. But I'm going to use this collection called default dict later in a later episode. Okay, so now we're going to just add current document ID to the list. Let's skip it. Current ID. So I think This is it. Basically, we need to store these indexes on disk. And to store it, I'm going to add another function, another method here. Hi, Tony. This is Python. Yes, you're right. Store on disk self and prefix, file prefix. So like I said, for now I'm going to just make super simple implementation. And what I'm going to do is just dump them as JSON. If you don't know what JSON is, don't bother. It's basically a way to serialize data, basically to convert Python dict into more human readable and into more human readable value. Just basically create a string representation of an object. It's called JSON because it comes from JavaScript. Line. Okay, you are right. Thank you, Jason. Okay. Super simple implementation. Inverted index file name is find file prefix. Actually, I think I'm going to just call it div. Why should I make it prefix? Okay, and now just open these files. I think it's like this. And then I'm going to dump our indexes. Okay, actually I don't remember how JSON dump works. I mean, what are the parameters? Okay, Python 2, just in case, Python 2, one Python 2, okay. Okay. So I think this should work. Okay, so it's almost done. Let's turn it into a script that we can invoke from command line. To do this, we are going to use this code. I'm going to copy fast and remove all this stuff. It's going to call index early on programming. It's going to take a couple of arguments. First of all, we need to We need to store URLs, sorry, store documents. I'm just going to put just and index directory. I'm going to create index in here, and right now I need to loop over downloaded URLs. How much, by the way, do we have? So we have only 37 URLs. Why is it so slow? I think something is wrong with Chrome. Okay. It says crawled a lot of URLs, but almost all URLs. That's weird. Something is wrong with Chrome. Okay, let's debug it. First of all, let's make sure that we don't have a Unicode problem. And I'm going to create a new directory for debugging purposes. For requests, let's set the log level to debug. And let's clean up a directory. The directory. And let's keep an eye on it. I'm going to check the number of crawled files of files every second. If you don't know what this comment does, I'm going to explain you briefly. So what it takes, it just takes this stuff and runs it every 1 second. It's pretty convenient. But I don't have it. God damn it. I think Mac should have it. Let's see if I can install it using Homebrew. Blah, 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 blah. You have not agreed to Xcode license. I'm going to agree to it. the runner's route. Okay. And I agree to this license. So let's install watch now. Because why don't it have watch? Let's see if I have watch. Yes. So what it does now, it just prints amount of crawled URLs. Let's keep an eye on it for maybe a minute. So far, so good. Thirty-six, and it stopped increasing. Maybe it doesn't close file automatically. As I can see, there is no problem with the unloading URLs because it gets to 200. Okay, it looks like it downloads them properly. At least right now, maybe we should close file. Let's see, maybe, I don't know. I'm not sure, I think it should close it automatically, but maybe I'm too used to C++, and in Python, maybe we should close it manually. All right. Let's do it. Let's do cleanup one more time and let's launch crawl again. Run watch. Okay, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Meanwhile, I'm going to look at this code to these logs. I think logs are better. I'm going just to keep my eye on this number, and meanwhile, I'm going to see if there is something interesting in logs. By the way, I should have saved it into a file. But maybe next run. Current page URL, next page URL. Let's uncomment this. Okay, 36. I hope it doesn't stop there. Okay, clearly there is a problem. So I think I'm going to add more debug output and see what's the problem. I suspect that maybe this line doesn't work. Maybe it works, maybe it doesn't. Let's put in a cell here. And now let's launch again. Okay, and let's do cleanup. And by the way, let's save it into a file. So I'm going to use T for this. So what I'm going to do now, this, what, okay. What this matrix does is basically it saves all the output of this stuff, including std out and std error. So both error and normal output strings, two strings, both them into this file. Could it be something with Reddit rate limiting for your user agent or something? Well, I don't think so, because I kept seeing 200 okay and 30 basically I kept seeing 200 okay and I kept seeing this status code, and if I remember correctly, it means redirect. And if it's a redirect, it's okay to probably, I think, because I think it just gets redirected, and then it after it gets redirected and requests the next URL to which it was redirected, and it gets 200 okay response. So I think it's worked like this. Request URL, get redirected, another URL, and request another URL, get 100 okay response. Because I keep seeing this alternating 200 and 302 responses. All right, let's see what's watch. I think I didn't do cleanup. Let's do cleanup. Let's launch it again. Let's see. And by the way, let's open log here. Maybe you see something interesting. So it's starting to crawl from page learn programming test. Current page is learn programming. Download URL. Okay. Start crawling. My current hypothesis is that it keeps crawling the same page, so it doesn't go to the next page for some reason. Maybe I'm wrong here. Let's see. Let's wait for a minute. Okay, and now I can sort this log. Current page is the same page. Okay. So what I'm doing right now is basically reloading a file in Vim. This is the amount of lines in the file. As you can see, it keeps increasing. Okay, so it went to, okay, clearly there is no problem here. It goes to another. It goes to another direct, oh, sorry, to another URL. So it's clearly not the problem. 37. Okay. By the way, I made a mistake here. I think it should be equals zero. I want to output every 100 URLs. And what I did is the opposite, actually. It outputted it 99 times from 100. Okay, it's again doesn't increase. Let's see what's the deal. All right, crawl at 55 OKs. there is some Unicode and code error. Maybe that's the problem. I don't know. Let's see. Okay. No, I download them properly. There are some Unicode and code errors, but I think it's no big deal. I don't need all the URLs now, and I'm going to fix problems like this later. I just want to make it work and then improve. Okay, log file. What's the problem? So I think I'm going to test another hypothesis. How much? I think I'm streaming for like an hour already. Okay. So I'm going to grab all these URLs. So all these messages that contain URLs. What I want to do is I want to check that I'm not crawling the same page for some reason. Maybe I made a mistake. Let's see current, where is it? Current page. Okay, it's clearly crawling the same page because it says current page is this. Then it says current page is this. I don't know if you can see, but the numbers change. This is just my numbers. As you can see, for example, this. The URL is the same. And why is so? I don't know. Let's see. Okay, I think I figured it out. It's because I don't handle errors properly. So I think the problem is here. An exception gets thrown here in downloaded URL, or maybe not there. Okay, let me check where it's exactly thrown. Line 39. Okay, line 39. Okay, it's get thrown here, right? And what happens next? It gets there, right? But I need to execute this code, right? Because if exceptions occur somewhere here, then this code isn't going to be executed, and it's not good. It's not what I want. So I think I found the error, and I think I'm going to fix it. Simply by moving this block of code there. Moving this. And there is still problem if let me fix it first. So basically, there is still problem if URL, or sorry, there is still problem if an exception occurs somewhere here or maybe here, because the crawler going to crash. But I think it's fine. I think it's okay. Let's do cleanup. I think I'm going to fix it later. Because, for example, what if I can't get next page URL? Then it means I probably should stop crawling. And if the program crashes at this point, it's okay. On the other hand, let's say if I can't parse all posts link, I think it's okay if program crashes. It doesn't crash actually, but it just throws an exception and terminates. It prints exception properly. And I think that's what I need. So I think there is actually no problem here, because if I can't extract post links or if I can't extract current page, next page URL, then it's safely, I can safely terminate. So it's fine. Okay, let's keep an eye on it and let's move back to the indexer. And I think I'm going to end this stream soon, maybe 10 more minutes. I really would like to finish work. Super simple implementation. I'm going to loop over downloaded documents somewhere in some method. I'm going to call it maybe crawl. Oh, sorry. Or maybe should I make it separate? What I'm thinking now is I need to make a decision. Basically, should I make this loop inside the indexer or should I make this loop somewhere else? And I think I'm going to create a new method. Like in this here. Sorry, it's not method, it's just a function. Index store documents there. Store documents there. And maybe index there too. What it's going to do is it's going to going to loop over this directory. Need to list all files in the directory. Or file in not list here some directory. Also it shouldn't be some directory, it should be stored documents here. Parse doc is going to be parse edit post. And I need to import it. I need to import all the stuff from YouTube. I need to import argparse as well. And I need to move this here. And then I'm going to just add I need to make sure that F is an actual file, not just file name. Probably parse ready pod. Yes. I need to open this file first. It's file name actually. opening file is open file name. Let me call file. Okay. Ready. And I need to split so actually parseRated post returns a string or some sort of Unicode string, and I need to split it into individual words. To do this, I'm going to do this the simplest possible way, which is just assuming that words separated by space. Then I'm going to add a to-do here. But for now, I want to make it work in. But for now, I want to make it super simple. And I'm going to call index. Okay, I forgot what's the method name. Add document. I'm going to rename it actually. Add index from zero. Okay, add document. I need to import another file. Another model. Okay. So I think it's time to test the code. There is enough file I've downloaded URLs to test it. I think it's time to stop it. Time to stop rolling and let's test our index. It's probably not going to work from the first try, but it's okay. Store documents. Yeah. And index here, I'm going to create a new div called indexes, and I'm going to put indexes there. Let's see. Valid syntax. Okay. From util import star a type of. Didn't work. Contain L. Main. Okay, I forgot to call create index from here. Create. And arc parse model knows where to put this data. Because I put dest parameter here. So it knows that I need to put store document dir value into this variable. Just wanted to explain how it works. So let's see. Global name OS is not defined. Okay, that's easy to fix. Let's see. Not such file or directory. Hey man, what text editor is that? It's called Vim. Pretty cool. It's not very beginner friendly. Basically, There are multiple modes. For example, right now I'm in normal mode and I just can't type text here. And to go, okay. And to go into insert mode, I need to type I, and then I go to insert mode, and then I can type text. So it's multimodular or multimodal or something like that. Basically, and by the way, if you need to quit Vim, if you need to exit from Vim, you type colon, then Q, and then hit enter. Because many beginners can't exit Vim. I certainly wasn't able when I first launched it. It's not very beginner friendly, but if you master it, it's super convenient. I can't live without it. Okay, so it's called Vim. Okay, let's go back to fixing. By the way, I don't know how coherent my response was, but I was explaining what's my text editor. Just in case there is some misunderstanding. Okay, let's go back to fixing this stuff. Open it file name. Okay, that's easy to fix. Let's just use old pass join. A lot of people love Vim, and I can see how productive it can be if you avoid it, but I can't wrap my head around it. Well, some people don't like Vim, and I think some people just... And I think Vim is not a great editor for some people. Some people, for example, prefer Emacs, which is another editor. Personally, I've never used it, and I really, really like multiple modes that Vim uses. I really like this concept. But it can be hard to master, and I think it's fine if you use any other editor. Yeah, I'm Russian, sorry. By the way, if I pronounce head as head, like I had a great idea, this is because in Russian we devoice ending consonants. So it's okay in Russian, but when I speak English, I subconsciously do this too. Okay, let's go back. So what I need to do is the problem here is that there is no file or directory, and this is true. There is no such file or directory because it's in the directory called crawled URLs view. And here it is. So basically, I need to look for file in storage document here. Okay. And by the way, I just remembered that I don't dump my URL to ID stuff. That's not good. Okay. So I'm going to dump it. Edit. I'm not going to bother. I'm going to add more copy paths. I'm going to duplicate more code packets. Later I'm going to fix it, but now I'm going to just disregard because I'm already streaming for like hour and a half, so I'm not going to. I want to keep it. I want to keep the length of the stream reasonably short, or not too long. Okay, so auto ID. Okay. I could see getting addicted to watching this. Thanks, man. That's good to hear. It's really nice to hear that you enjoy my videos. And JSON dump. Self URL to ID. Basically, there is a lot of duplication. I don't like it, but I want to just make it work. Format index file, URL to ID file. Okay. Global name. Hopefully this will be a gift to watch later. Yes, they will be on YouTube. YouTube automatically saves the live broadcast. So you will be able to watch it, and the URL actually will stay the same. So it's pretty convenient. You can just save this URL. So let's go back to fixing the program. 63. Okay, because it's opened file. Global name beautiful soap is not defined. Okay. That's easy enough to fix. I need to add one more import here. Expected string of buffer. Damn it, 5. Okay. I put split into wrong place. It needs to look like this. Basically, we need to start the document and then split, and not the other way around. Let's see. I don't know what's happening now. Okay, it did something. But it didn't. Okay, I forgot to call another method. Indexer dump. What's the name of it? Store on disk. Okay, I'm going to call it dump on disk. I like this more. Or, okay, save on disk. Save on disk sounds nice. Let's see. Okay, written. Global name JSON is not defined. Okay. That's easy enough to fix. Okay. All right, work it. By the way, it's probably not very human readable. Not very convenient. So There is a nicer way to dump JSON. You need to specify indent. And I'm going to specify it as 4. Wow, 17 people watching. That's nice to see. If you didn't watch from the beginning, you can watch it later. Okay, it indexed. Okay, let's see what's inside these files. And basically it's forward index. Like I said, it's going to be really simple, very straightforward. It says that document number 1 has these words: build, recent, redesigned, view, implemented, stylish, okay, and so on. Let's find second document. Okay, I need the best option to learn SQL online free or reasonably. Okay, nice. Probable. Okay, some code. Hey, I'm really new to programming, and at the moment I'm creating a casino app for Android. Okay, there is some code. So 157 documents. That's as much as if adding crawled use new. Sorry. Okay, why there is more? That's interesting. Okay, probably because I count this and this. Let's see what's inside in your dependence. Severe. First of all, I see a problem here. And the problem here is that there is an empty word. Not nice. And by the way, it says that it occurs multiple times in document number 23. Okay, that's weird. Let's fix it now. But let's see first if there is something interesting. Okay, let's see if there is a word Python. Okay. It says that the word Python is in document number 26. In document number 116, and so on. So like I said, if, for example, we want to find all documents that contain the word Python, we can do it really, really quickly. So we have only four documents out of 157 containing the word Python. So we need So that's only 2.5% of all collection, and we save. And we have, later we are going to save a lot of time by not scanning the whole collection. We can just use these four documents. I hope this makes sense. I hope I explained why we need inverted index. Let's see what's weird here. Basically, I noticed there is something like, Python, like this, Python/n, Python/n. That's not good. We are going to fix it later, probably. But first of all, let's do, game board, what? Okay, so first of all, we add a document multiple times, right? So for example, the word 100 contains, appears twice, first in document number 24, and then again in document number 24. By the way, we actually need both. We need to know both, but what we need to know is actually not just that it occurred in some place, but also its position. So let's fix it. Okay, so I'm going to show what enumerate does. Let's say we have a list. I love Python. And this is our document. So what enumerate does, it basically enumerates all these words. So pretty nice. Enumerate word. Okay, not here. For position and word in enumerate parsed text. Position and current ID. So let's store not just ID, but also word position. It's going to be very useful when we start generating snippets. So if you don't know what snippets is, let's say snippets or annotations is basically these things. See this text called snippets. It's called snippet or sometimes annotation. And it's convenient to see such small and concise representation of a document. We need to generate this, and to generate this, we will need positions of words. So I'm going to store positions of words as well. Let's see how if it works. Global name position is independent because I made a typo here. There's the chat. Would you know how to build a torrent site? I don't know how to build a torrent site, but I think it's pretty interesting given that, given the news with Pirate Bay. Okay, so I launched I built indexes one more time, and right now there are positions. So for example, our Python is on 125th place in the document number 26. And like I said, it's going to be more, and it's probably my, and right now you probably have only basic idea why we need this, but we actually going to use it in probably the next episode or maybe the next two or three episodes. Okay, I think it's time to end the stream. I don't know how much. It's already almost 2 hours. So I'm going to commit my work. I'm going to get that crawler pipe, get that indexer pipe, get that util pipe. I'm back, just adding the stuff to Git. Let's see. So what I've done is script for crawling. I think I need to commit more script for indexer. Work on indexer plus script for. Bye, James. Work on indexer script for global. Yeah. Okay. Let's push it on GitHub. Okay. I'm going to here. Here is my repository. If you want to play with code, if you want to play with code, you can use this URL. And I'm going to update it with, I'm going to update the description later. One more question. Okay. Just to clarify, you first index every word you search for, and the later when you search for the word, it will only search the pages which have already been indexed. Yeah, it will only search for the pages that's already been indexed, and due to inverted index structure, we will search only the documents that contain these words. This word, even in our small collection, only 2% of documents have the word Python. So I think it's going to save our us a few seconds. So are there any questions? I think I won't write any code, but I can answer more questions if you want. Let's wait for a couple more minutes because there is some buffering and going to
documents that
going to launch my own video. I've been streaming for like 2 hours. That's a lot. Okay, I'm going to wait for questions. When I'm streaming again, I'm going to stream the next Saturday. And maybe I'm going to stream on Wednesday or Thursday. I don't know actually when I'm going to stream, but it's certainly going to be on Saturday, but maybe there will be another shorter, like maybe half an hour stream on Wednesday. If you want to receive updates, you can subscribe to my channel. You can also subscribe to my Twitter, follow me on Twitter. And I can't publish the link. I'm going to publish username, my username. You can follow me, and I'm going to post any updates. And there is also a Perunity group. Perunity is the website I'm working on with a friend. Sorry. Okay. Here is the group. And I'm also posting updates here. If you want, okay, it's already detected. Oops. So I'm also posting updates on Pirunity and what else? By the way, you can, here's my email. You can ask me any questions on email, or you can PM me on Reddit, send me a private message. So I'm going to wait for one more minute to see if there are any questions, but basically it's the end of the stream. So you can just close it now if you want. Thanks for watching. It's really great that you like my streams. It's nice to hear. Don't hesitate to email me or send me a private message or whatever. I will be glad to answer your questions. And every video that I stream will be eventually available on YouTube. So don't worry if you miss a live stream. You can always watch it later. So I think the minute has passed. Basically, thanks for watching and bye. Okay, I'm ending the broadcast. Is there any questions? Let's see. No questions. Thank you, George.